Hey guys, welcome back. This is Elodia. I'm going to show you a build on Pacific that you can use to beat all your friends really easily. So what we're going to do is spawn exactly there, okay? And we're going to go for a really quick T2. It's really important that you follow this exactly, otherwise your timings will be off. So we're going to start with a T1 factory, okay? Then two fabrication ships, so control click twice. And then without control, we click the narwhal to build that continuously. Then with our commander, metal extractor, PGN, and then bot factory somewhere close by. So just so we're not walking too much with our commander. And let's see if I can get it. Oh, saw some white there. Okay, yeah, okay, so we got it. And then some PGNs after that. With our, oh, looks like he's having some internet problems. But yeah, there's not really much counter to this build. You don't need to scout your opponent, you don't need to know what he's doing. So, and there's not like a lot of micro as well. I'm gonna try and keep this really basic. I'm not gonna try and micro a lot of the units myself, as I normally would, just to kind of illustrate to you how to do the build. So with our bot factory, we want to get our combat fabrication bot first, so what we're going to do is control click the fabrication bot and then the combat fabrication bot to get that order right. Then without control we're going to get docks, and then we're going to patrol the bot factory up there. So it's kind of like a set and forget to protect our island. You don't really need to think about it for the rest of the game. And after that we're going to get the triangle medal with our fabrication ships, and our first frigate is going to go down to the triangle to protect against gunboat rushes or whatever. Okay, so our second fabrication ship, after we built that second one, that second mech, we're going to bring him down to the triangle. And then after that, we're going to get our second fabricator down to the triangle like that. So everything's nicely timed out. We're going to get our fabrication, our combat fab out to reclaim the trees. Now our second frigate is going to go over here just to protect against any gunboats that are coming around this direction. Going to get the metal and then AA turrets and then some PGNs with our little bot fabricator. After our second frigate, we're going to go with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Fabrication ships, and that's when we're going to start our T2. Okay, so just get some more pigeons. Okay, and in the triangle, we want to get a radar and the torpedo launcher. So we're going to start our T2 with this fabricator, okay, and then the next four fabricators are going to go onto this factory and assist it so that we're getting up really quickly. Commander, we're going to assisted as well. Now with our T2 factory, we want to get a control click on just once on the T2 fabricator, okay? We want to get one of those very quickly. And the commander, we're going to assist the factory after he's done with the PGNs, okay? Now we've got a little bit of downtime so we can like burn his trees with the docks that we have, try and like annoy him on the island if he's there. And then now we're going to get two combat fabrication bots, okay? And we're going to reclaim all of the trees on that island. And now we want to get these two medals. Well, actually, we're going to get this medal. I forgot. And then we get an AA turret right in the middle there. We get the T2 mechs and then torpedo launcher and then walls, okay? Just to kind of protect that side. Okay, so reclaim those trees. If he kills our combat fabricators, it's not really a big deal. I mean, it is a bonus that we get that medal, but again, just remember when you're playing this build, don't panic if he seems to be killing your stuff. Because you're just going to ride it out on the T2 medal that you're about to come up with. Okay, so just as this factory is about to finish, we're going to suicide send all of our fabrication ships to just randomly build metal everywhere. Again, this is kind of like a bonus, we don't really need it. It's just to make sure that we're not using the energy with our T1 fabs, and that they're doing something actually useful. If our opponent kills them, no big deal, don't need to panic, okay? So, just gonna wait for this to finish. Just send some docs out if you find you got nothing else to do. Okay, so it's done, we're gonna start with that T2 metal. Easy peasy, easy peasy. Now the whole goal is to make sure that it's building at 100%, okay? So every time our metal is heading towards zero, we wanna pause our factories so that we're not using it. That all the metal is being prioritized into the T2 fabber, okay? So we're gonna pause it now, so that our T2 fabber is building as close to 100% as possible. Okay, so it's gonna attack through. No big problem. We're probably gonna lose those fabricators, but yeah, doesn't matter too much. Probably just build a torpedo launcher to be safe if you want to. So just build one there, and that'll take care of those two ships. Okay, so radar here. We want to have lots of redundant radar, so if he takes one out, we're going to have another one back up. That's going to be really important later on when we start pumping out our Leviathan so that we can maximize their range. Build some random stuff there. Okay, so we're going to get the Triangle T2 Max next. And then our second fabrication ship after our first Leviathan. He's gonna kill those fabs, but again, doesn't matter. Now, just reclaim some more trees. This is kind of like the boring part because we're just waiting for everything to build up, and our opponent can't exactly attack us and finish us off. So. Just get another T1 factory to spend some metal, just finish the T2 factory. Oh, and then we need to get the metal storage before we move to the triangle so that we're not wasting metal when our T2 fab is moving. So we're going to get frigates. More frigates to escort our battleship. Well, we lost our T1 fab, so just build another one. Okay, he's going to bomb our combat fabs, but they've already served their purpose, so it doesn't really matter. So at this point, when your opponent scouts you, he's probably going to either go with lots of bombers, so we can get flak. Just flak everywhere to protect everything so we can't do anything. Or he's going to spam subs. If he spams subs, you just need to get advanced torpedo launches, no big deal. And just camp your Leviathans behind them and slowly push forward. We haven't seen him go sub, so we're just going to continue getting T2 metal. Just kind of just kill everything in the middle that he has built up. Now what happens is, because he's seen us go turtle, what usually he'll do is try and expand metal everywhere, which will kind of make him unbalanced in terms of energy. So right now he's probably prioritizing energy, so if we kill his metal, he's going to have lots of energy but no metal to use that energy with, okay? So just build more stuff to kill him with. So we're gonna need a Kraken now. Yeah, it's looking good so far. We probably have a very big metal lead, so we can do a lot of stuff. Get some energy, of course. Just, yeah, watch your energy. Like, usually, because he killed our T1 bot fabricator before, we were kind of behind on the energy, but usually it times out very well. Okay, so just get some more T1 factories for the frigates, get our energy storage. And at 10 minutes, what we want to do exactly at 10 minutes is build the deep space radar, which is exactly timed out so that he can't kill us with any orbital shenanigans. Okay, so you don't really need to scout him, just at 10 minutes build the deep space just to be safe. Okay, let's get more frigates before we kind of push out. There's our little bot fabricator. So we're gonna start getting that metal again. And just build some stuff. With our Kraken, we're just gonna send him around by himself and see what we can kill. It's more like just to harass the opponent. Kind of shut down all of his T1 metal if he has any. And at the same time, we're gonna push forward so that he can't really respond so well to our Kraken. Just attack move with our docks. Just randomly do that. Set and forget. Don't really need to micro anything, okay? Very simple. If they die, they die. If they don't die, then you got scouting information. At this point, the docks are kind of useless, okay? So just use the Kraken, move it around, and kill stuff. Now we're going to get another T2 fabrication bot because our economy is booming a lot now and we need more build power to use it. Let's get some flak, some advanced torpedo launches, just spam it everywhere. But we're a bit late on our deep space, 11 minutes, but that's okay. We saw that he went lots of bombers and stuff, so we know that he couldn't have gotten the orbital so early if he did get it. Okay, now just get some radar to support our Leviathans and some energy. Some flak to prevent the bomber snipe, and then some thingies. Just push forward now and we can kind of kill him. Okay, so he's gone Kraken. That's no big deal. We have enough frigates to deal with that. His T2 was a bit late. So as a result, we are able to kind of crush his base right now. Just keep building stuff. Okay, so he's gonna try and push around the back. This is kind of a common last stand kind of strat. So all you need to do is build like some advanced torpedo launches again and you'll be totally fine. Let's just kill that Kraken. Let's get some more metal, keep expanding, and then we need to spend that metal instead of expanding actually, because we're running a surplus. I was going to try and attack us with bombers, but it's not going to work. Especially with the last patch where they gave AoE damage to AA missiles, you don't want to really build planes anymore, especially on Pacific. It's kind of counterintuitive, but just trust me on that. Just waypoint random places with the Kraken. And then, no micro needed, just put one waypoint into the middle of his base with all your ships. Okay. If you're playing against an opponent who's doing the same thing as you, maybe you might need to micro your Leviathans to target down his Leviathans and to keep your ships at range, but generally you don't need to do much. So just keep building stuff. Get more delicious metal and some factories to spend that metal. Yeah, so he can't push through, he's gonna notice that, and he's pulling back right now. And you can just keep pushing him away with advanced torpedo launches if you want. Okay, so the game's pretty much over now. He has no metal, he has no production really, he has no T2, so let's try and finish this really quickly. We have 300 metal, and he has, let's see, has nothing there, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, so he's got about 55 metal or so. That's the power of going with the T2 metal really quickly, because you can kind of snowball. Okay, so I'm gonna call GG now. GG. Oh, that's pretty cool. I don't know if you noticed that, like, I turned off the factory so that the commander was building the Leviathan, so the Leviathan was complete, but it was stuck in the T2 factory. It's kind of interesting. So yeah, just follow this build really, try and follow it exactly, so that your timings are not going to be off. And you should basically be able to beat anyone, really. Unless, of course, they're using the same build, yeah. This is probably it. Okay, there we go, GG. Well played by our opponent. He did get quite a lot of metal, actually, in a lot of units.